Good evening all. Now Zoom has become a wide app which is used for video conferencing. But as of now, to increase the security features, they have made some amount of changes. Previously, a host will be given a Zoom login and password. Once they get into the thing, the participants can join the meeting with the Zoom meeting ID, which is a 10-digit number. But now, due to the added security features, some amount of changes has been done, and both in the desktop version, the mode of inviting the participants is different, and in the mobile version, the mode of inviting the participant is different. First, in this video, since many of them are using the mobile, how a particular host should be in a position to join the meeting, and second, how the particular participants should be in a position to join the meeting, and what are the changes that has been done, will be very clearly dealt in this video. Now let's go into the thing. So I am having totally two mobiles. So this you consider the host mobile, and this mobile you consider as the participant mobile who are going to join the meeting. So in this mobile, first I am going to host the meeting. So I am the host. So I am going into the Zoom app. I should be in a position to sign in. So in the case of sign in, already I have the username typed in. So my password, if you have password, you type, that depends upon the mobile phones. Otherwise, I am unlocking with my fingerprint sensor. So once this is over, I should be in a position to go for the new meeting. So once I will be starting the meeting, see here very clearly, once the meeting is set up, see here, this is the newly generated, the instant meeting 719-736-320. Previously, the participants would have a Zoom meeting ID, which is a 10-digit number. But 719-736-320 is the new meeting ID, and the password is 267169. I'll ensure that once you log out, a particular host is log out or signing out of the device, again they're generating after 10 minutes or 5 minutes, again they're logging in. Each and every time, a meeting, new meeting ID and a new password will be generated. Please keep this in mind. Suppose a particular host is going to host 4 sessions, means for 4 sessions the instant username or the instant meeting ID and the password will be different. So this you keep in mind. Second, now as already I have told, this is the host, this is the participants mobile, how they should be in a position to join the meeting. So here what they should go, they should join a meeting. In the join in meeting, they should not enter the Zoom meeting ID which the host has entered. Now the instantly generated meeting ID is 719-736-320. So this I have entered, and I'll be in a position to join the meeting. While joining the meeting, a window pop up suggesting the password. So here password I should type 267 and 169. So I'll be in a position to join the meeting. So here you'll be getting the video preview, join with video or without video. That then here it, in the particular thing, the host will be in a position to admit that particular meeting, and so you have to write the admit. So once that, now you will be in a position to, the host or the host will be in a position to accept the participant, and the participant then only will be in a position to join the meeting. This is the new security changes that has been made. Kindly note this changes. Once the meeting got ended, gets over, what you have to do is that the particular meeting, you please end the meeting and you come here. Once what you have to go, then again you go here, you come to the home page, you'll be having settings. Kindly you unlock, you sign out of the particular device. Now the everything will be over. The host will be in a position to come out of the meeting. Again, if they are going to host a meeting, say 4 sessions in a particular day, after a gap of 10 minutes, they are going to start the particular section. Again, a 9-digit member ID and the 6-digit password will be generated, that you have to share with the list of participants. Then only they will be in a position to do the thing. Apart from that, in the setting itself, we will be having a URL code. You can transfer that URL or share that URL code, so that the participant, just by clicking the URL code, will be in a position to join the meeting. So these are the changes that the Zoom app I've made, I have updated very clearly. From tomorrow, any sections or everything from now onwards, if they're going to start, this is the main parameter you have to follow. If you have any queries or any doubt, I'll be just post in the comment section, I'll be explaining, and I'll be in a position to share some of the screenshots. Thank you.